कोर्स सेरिकल्चर फर्स्ट ईयर पेपर वन मोरिकल्चर यूनिट सेवन कल्टीवेशन एंड कल्चरल प्रैक्टिसेस पार्ट वन प्रिपेयर्ड बाय टी करुणा गवर्नमेंट जूनियर कॉलेज शादनगर मायसेल्फ यूसुफ अहमद गवर्नमेंट वोकेशनल जूनियर कॉलेज नलगुंडा जी राजू गवर्नमेंट वोकेशनल जूनियर कॉलेज नलगुंडा। कमिंग टू द यूनिट सेवन कल्टीवेशन एंड कल्चरल प्रैक्टिसेस। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द मलबेरी कल्टीवेशन मेथड्स। Cultivation methods such as irrigated mulberry, rain-fed mulberry, and the various varieties of mulberry to be adopted, keeping in mind the cultivation areas. So here, coming to the introduction part, mulberry silkworm is a monophagous insect which feeds on mulberry leaves alone. Hence, the cultivation of mulberry is the most important activity for rearing of silkworms and production of cocoons. So here, in order to get quality cocoons, mulberry leaves are to be cultivated qualitatively and quantitatively, so that must be able to, in this planning, we must be able to assess the capacity of mulberry garden, how much disease free layings are to be reared depending upon the mulberry leaf available. So this is the skilled point. One must have the skill to assess the quantity and quality of the leaf before starting the silkworm rearing. And another point is weeds. Weeds, what are weeds here? Weeds are unwanted, undesirable plants that interfere with utilization of land and water resources, and the weeds adversely affect the main crop. Here, the weeds can also be referred to as the plants out of place. Weeds include all type of undesirable plants, grasses, aquatic plants, etc. Weeds are great menace to the fields as they compete with the main crops for fertilizer, soil moisture, and plant nutrients. So these weeds compete with the fertilizer, soil moisture, and nutrients. The intensity of weed attack varies at field level. The weed attack depends upon the type of weed species, duration of weed infestation, severity of weed infestation, and climatic conditions which favors weed infestation. The weeds reduce the annual crop production for 10 to 25%. This variation depends upon the degree of weed attack and weed control measures. So here the weeds reduce the annual crop production to from 10% to 25%. So this is a great loss to the farmer. Weeds compete with the main crop for nutrients, soil moisture, light, aeration, space, fertilizers, etc. crop yields drastically come down if the weed growth is not controlled. It is estimated that 1 kilogram of weed growth in the field corresponds to reduce 1 kilogram of crop growth. So even during the drought conditions also, the weeds survive better than the desert plants. Therefore, intercultivation at regular intervals is more important, not only in mulberry crop but in all the type of agricultural crops. Weeding is more important as it affects the main crop qualitatively and quantitatively. So here, even the drought conditions also, the weeds survive better than the desert plants. Therefore, it is most and more important intercultivation is to be taken up at regular intervals so that weeds can be eradicated. Coming to the Telugu version here, kalpu mokkalanu nirmulistu పొలంలోని నేలను గుల్లగా చేయటం వల్ల వర్షం నీరు నేల లోతుకు ప్రవహించి మొక్క పోషణకు తోడ్పడుతుంది. దీనివల్ల గాలి నేల పొరలోనికి ప్రవేశించడానికి అవకాశం కలుగుతుంది. సాధారణంగా ఏమిటంటే కలుపు మొక్కలు పొలంలోని పోషక పదార్థాలు నీరు గాలి వెలుతురు మొదలైన వాటి కోసము ఈ మల్బెరీ మొక్కలతో పోటీ పడతాయి. ఇక్కడ కొన్ని కలుపు మొక్కలు పైరు మొక్కలతో సన్నిహిత సంబంధం ఏర్పరచుకొని నేరుగా మొక్క నుంచే నీటిని ఆహార పదార్థాలను గ్రహిస్తాయి. అందుచేత మొక్కల పెరుగుదల తగ్గి బలహీనమై పంట దిగుబడి అనేది తగ్గుతుంది. మల్బెరీ చిరుదశలోనే ఈ మల్బెరీ తోటలోని కలుపును అదుపు చేయాలి. కలుపు మొక్కలు చీడలకు ఆశ్రయం ఇచ్చి వాటి అభివృద్ధికి తోడ్పడతాయి. ఆ తర్వాత ఇక్కడ ప్రారంభము నుంచే చేపట్టే పెంపకములోని పనులు, what is called as initial cultural operations. మల్బెరీ మొక్కలు నాటిన 6 మాసాల లోపు 2 సార్లు కలుపు తీయాలి. నాట్లు వేసిన 2 నెలల తర్వాత ఒకసారి, మరి ఆ తర్వాత 2-3 నెలలకు మరొకసారి కలుపును తీయాలి. వరుసల మధ్యలో 15 సెంటీమీటర్ల లోతు తవ్వటం వలన మట్టి బాగా వదులై కలుపు మొక్కలను వేళ్లతో సహా పెకలించటానికి వీలవుతుంది. దీనివల్ల మల్బెరీ పెరిగేందుకు మంచి ఉత్తేజం దొరుకుతుంది. కలుపును మల్బెరీ వాటిని మొదటి సంవత్సరం మల్బెరీ నాటిన మొదటి సంవత్సరంలోనే అదుపు చేయాలి. ఈ ప్రక్రియలో నేల గుల్లవటమే కాకుండా గాలి ప్రసారము బాగా జరిగి మొక్కలకు వ్యాధులు రాకుండా ఉంటాయి. అదేవిధముగా మట్టి వదులుగా ఉండటం వల్ల నీరు అనేది తేలికగా భూమిలోనికి ఇంకి మొక్కలకు కావలసిన తేమను నిల్వ చేస్తుంది. సో హియర్ కమింగ్ టు ది ఇంగ్లీష్ వర్సన్, మెథోడికల్ కట్టింగ్ ఆఫ్ సర్టెన్ మల్బరీ బ్రాంచెస్ పీరియోడికలీ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ప్రూనింగ్. So in order to maintain a certain shape to the plant, and in order to control the disease and pest to the mulberry plants, pruning is very necessary. In other terms, pruning in mulberry may be defined as the methodical removal of certain branches of the plants so as to give the plant, number one is a convenient shape and size to the plant. And the second one is to increase the leaf yield, the most important point. Why we do pruning? Because to increase the leaf yield also, not only control of diseases and pest, but also to increase the leaf yield also, so that the farmer can get, so that the farmer can brush more number of DFLs, so that he can produce more quantity of cocoons. Not only this, to improve the leaf quality also. So here, trimming. So what is trimming here? Shaping of the plants into a convenient for is necessary for easy harvest and intercultivation. That is ploughing and middle rows. Coming to the garden implements. So what are the garden implements used to control these weeds? The important implements that are commonly used in mulberry cultivation are as follows. These are grouped into 7 types. They are digging implements, gardening implements, transplanting implements, propagating. So here, the garden implements are 7 types as I told. They are digging implements, gardening implements, transplanting implements, propagating implements, pruning implements, leveling implements, irrigation implements. Coming to the digging implements. So what are the digging implements used? What for? They are used for light digging, channels preparation. For example, hand guddali, it is made up of cast iron with a wooden handle, used for digging the soil up to the 8 to 10 inches depth. It can also be used for intercultural operations. And the second implement is the crowbar. It is iron made, 6 feet long with 2 inches diameter with one sharp flat end, used for deep digging. Not only that, making pits in hard soil and also to move stones. And the third one is the pickaxe. This is made up of cast iron measuring 2 inches with one sharp end and other end being flat and sharp. There is a round hole for fixing wooden handle. It is used for deep digging, opening of trenches, digging pits, loosening of the soil and uprooting the weeds. And the second type of garden implements are digging fork, hand cultivator, hoe and rake. And the first one is the digging fork. It has 4 long pointed prongs measuring 12 inches long with a wooden handle. The digging fork is used for leveling, digging and also useful in hill areas. It is better implement for loosening the moist soil and mixing manures in pits. Second one is the hand cultivator. It is used to loosen the soil during the intercultivation and uprooting grass and other weeds. It is made up of iron with 5 prongs which are curved, pointed at the free end. All these prongs are tied to a handle. The third one is hoe and rake. It is a combination of hoe and rake with a hole in the middle for filling in the handle. The sharp blade is 14 cm long, while prog part is 15 cm long. The hoe rake is used for digging for intercultivation operations, loosening the soils and weeding. And another one is the garden fork. It is made of cast iron of 4 long and aluminium make with form pointed prongs projecting from the handle. It is used for intercultivation and leveling of the soil. And coming to the another type of implements, the transplanting implements. One is the spade, another one is the shovel, another one is the dibbler, and another one is the transplanted trowel. First is the spade. It has a broad blade with one end free and other end is fixed to a handle. So spade is used for uprooting the saplings, seedlings from the nursery bed, मिक्सिंग ऑफ मैन्यूर्स फॉर लाइट डिगिंग, लूजनिंग ऑफ द सॉइल एंड टू प्रिपेयर इरिगेशन चैनल्स, मेकिंग रिडजेस एंड फर्रोस एंड यूज ऑफ द शॉवल. इट हैज ए लॉन्ग वुडन हैंडल फिक्स्ड टू योर ब्लेड विथ टेपरिंग और फ्लैट एंड मेजरिंग 3 feet लॉन्ग. इट इज टू कैरी और लिफ्ट द सॉइल. इट कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज फॉर ट्रांसप्लांटिंग प्रोसेस. एंड अनदर वन इज डिब्लर. इट इज अ फाइन शार्प इम्प्लीमेंट. इट इज यूज टू मेक होल्स एट द टाइम ऑफ ट्रांसप्लांटिंग ऑफ सीडलिंग्स सैपलिंग्स. इट कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज फॉर पिट सिस्टम प्लांटेशन. एंड अनदर वन इज द ट्रांसप्लांटिंग ट्रॉवल. दीज आर गार्डन एंड ट्रांसप्लांटिंग ट्रॉवल्स डिफर जस्ट इन साइज. Both can be used in mulberry garden, generally made of aluminium. It is used to lift the saplings or seedling along with some soil without disturbing the root system of the plant. Here you see the different type of garden implements. Digging fork, it has 4 long pointed prongs measuring 12 inches long with a wooden handle. So this digging fork is used for leveling, digging, and also useful in hilly areas. So it is used for loosening the moist soil and mixing manures in the pits. And the another garden fork, it is made up of cast iron. Cast of 4 long or aluminium make with form pointed prongs projecting from the handle. It is used for intercultivation operations, leveling of the soil. And the other one is the garden towel. And another one is the garden fork is also seen. Segager is also seen. Digging fork, transplanting towel, hand fork, garden rake, water rose can is seen. Wheelbarrow, it is used for transporting manure, fertilizer, seedlings, saplings. It rests on 2 legs and moves with the gentle push. And the transplanting trowel, these are garden and transplanting trowels differ just in size. Both can be used for mulberry garden, generally made of aluminium. It has a handle and cone shaped spoon used to lift the sapling or seedling along with some soil without disturbing the root system. And the another one is the water can. It is made up of 24 gauge sheet. The can is 24 inches diameter with 12 inches height with 6 inches height along 15 inches pipe with 4 diameter rows is fitted to the bottom of the can. So this water can is rose water can is used for watering the nursery beds, seed beds, potted plants to avoid washing away and to avoid the soil erosion and the damage of the young seedlings. And the another one is the hand cultivator. Loosened the soil during intercultivation methods, uprooting grass and other weeds. It is made up of iron with 5 prongs which are curved, pointed at the free end. All these prongs are held tightly to the handle. And these are all the garden implements, transplanting implements you've seen in the figure, used for various purposes in the mulberry field. So here in the figure you see some implements used in the mulberry field, mainly the transplanting implements. The shovel is seen. It has a long wooden handle fixed to a blade with tapering or flat end, measuring 3 feet long. It is to carry or lift the soil. It can also be used for transplanting process. And the another one are the transplanting trowel. These are garden and transplanting trowels, differ just in size. Both can be used for mulberry garden, generally made of aluminium. It has a handle of and cone shaped spoon to lift the sapling or seedling along with the some soil without disturbing the root system. And coming to the propagation implements, these implements are used for propagating mulberry plants. Propagation activities: one is the bill hook, second one is the budding knife, third one is grafting knife, the fourth one is budding cum grafting knife. So these are all the propagating implements. Bill hook, it is a thick long blade measuring 12 inches with a 6 foot handle made up of completely iron. There is a single and doubled edge bill hook. The edge is very sharp to cut big mulberry branches. It is used especially for the preparation of cuttings to be used for the shoot rearing purpose. So next one is the budding knife. It has a single blade, 17 centimeters long, can be folded into a socket of 8 centimeters long. The other end of the socket has 2.5 centimeter size budder to lift the bud after making necessary incision. For budding purposes, this budding knife is used in the process of tea budding, patch budding, and so on. And the another one is the grafting knife, used for the grafting purpose. It is also similar to the budding knife, but lacking the bladder. It is used for grafting both stem and the root system to cut the plant material, the stalk and the scion. And the another one is the budding cum grafting knife. So it is a combination of both budding cum grafting, measuring 5.5 centimeters, 5 centimeters long, and can be folded into only one socket. It is used for budding as well as the grafting purposes. And the next one are the pruning implements used for pruning the mulberry plants in order to give a shape and size to the mulberry plants to avoid the pests and diseases. It is one of the most important cultivation practices, which is aimed to increase the number of branches so as to improve the leaf yield and protect the plants from diseases and pests and proper aeration to the plant. The first one is the first pruning implement is the pruning sickle. It is made up of cast iron with 5 feet long wooden handle. The inner edge is like a saw blade. It is used for cutting the small branches. And the second one is the pruning saw. The saw is of 12 or 14 inches long with proper wooden handle. It is used to cut thicker branches while pruning the plant. The third one is the pruning knife. It has 4 inches folding blade or fixed blade with one sharp end fixed to a wooden handle. It is used for cutting thinner branches. And the another important pruning implement is the secateur. It has two stout curved jaws which are clutched with a powerful spring. It is 10 inches long implement with two separate handles with two jaws. The spring improves its functioning. It is used to cut the thinner branches of the plant. And the another one is the another pruning implement is the garden shear. It has two metal blades with plain edges with notch and wooden handle. It is used for clipping and pruning of the mulberry plants. And the another important one is the tree pruner. It has a very sharp stout knife. It can be made to move with spring action attached to the handle. And coming to the other implements, one is the rose water can for watering nursery beds, seed beds and the potted plants, and the iron pan used for transporting sand, soil, farmyard manure, etc., and wheelbarrow for transporting manure, fertilizer, seedlings as well as saplings. So these are all some of the other implements. So here you see in the figure some common pruning tools. One is the secateur, pruning sickle, pruning saw, pruning knife, garden shear, and tree pruner also is seen. These are all the pruning implements. It is one of the more important cultivation practices aimed to increase the number of branches so as to improve the leaf yield. Pruning sickle. It is a sickle with 5 inches long wooden handle. The inner edge is like saw blade. It is used for cutting small branches. Pruning saw. The saw is of 12 or 14 inches long with a proper wooden handle. It is used to cut thicker branches while pruning the plants. And the pruning knife, it has a 4 inches folding blade or fixed blade with one sharp end fixed to a wooden handle. It is used for cutting the thinner branches. Secateur, it has two stout curved jaws which are clutched with a powerful spring. It is 10 inches long implement with two separate handles for two jaws. The spring improves its functioning. It is used for cutting the thinner branches of the plant. While coming to the tree pruner, it has very sharp stout knife. Can be made to move with spring action attached to the handle. It is too strong to cut thick stouts in a tree. Have a height of 5 feet and above. These are all the pruning tools used in the mulberry garden while pruning. So panimutlalo aneka rakalaina panimutlu unnai. Totalo upayoginche panimutlu mokkalanu teese panimutlu, transplanting implements, ade vidhamga propagation implements, pratyutpatti vyavasthaku upayoginche panimutlu mariyu pruning implements, moka kotaku upayoginche panimutlu mariyu other implements, water can ganivandi, kunda ganivandi, iron wheelbarrow kanivandi, ivanni kuda aneka rakamaina panimutlu మల్బరీ తోటలో తోడ్పడతాయి. అదేవిధంగా కలుపు నిర్మూలనలో అనేక పనిముట్లు ముఖ్యముగా కూర్పి, తోళిక, బిల్హుక్, పార, దంతి, చాళ్లతో నెట్టుతూ కలుపు తీసే పరికరాలలో చక్రపు దంతి, మెట్ట దంతి, మూడు పళ్ళ దంతి, పళ్ళ చక్రాల దంతి మొదలైనవి మల్బెరీ తోటలలో కలుపును నిర్మూలించే పరికరాలు ఉన్నాయి. అండ్ నౌ కమింగ్ టు ది అసైన్మెంట్ క్వశ్చన్స్, షార్ట్ క్వశ్చన్స్. సో వాట్ ఆర్ వీడ్స్, డిఫైన్ వీడ్స్. సో హియర్ ద వీడ్స్ ఆర్ ద అన్వాంటెడ్ అండ్ అన్డిజైరబుల్ ప్లాంట్స్ దట్ ఇంటర్ఫేర్ విత్ ద యూటిలైజేషన్ ఆఫ్ ల్యాండ్, వాటర్ రిసోర్సెస్ అండ్ ది అడ్వర్సలీ ఎఫెక్ట్ ద మెయిన్ క్రాప్. వీడ్స్ కెన్ ఆల్సో బి రిఫర్డ్ టు యాజ్ ద ప్లాంట్స్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ప్లేస్. సో దీస్ వీడ్స్ కాంపిట్ విత్ ద మెయిన్ క్రాప్స్ ఫర్ న్యూట్రియంట్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సాయిల్, సాయిల్ మాయిశ్చర్, లైట్, ఏరేషన్, స్పేస్, ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ ఎక్సెట్రా. సార్ అండ్ కమింగ్ టు ది సెకండ్ క్వశ్చన్, నేమ్ సమ్ డిగ్గింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. డిగ్గింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ ది హ్యాండ్ కుడ్డలి, క్రోబార్ అండ్ పికాక్స్. దీస్ ఆర్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ది డిగ్గింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. అండ్ కమింగ్ టు థర్డ్ క్వశ్చన్, నేమ్ సమ్ గార్డెన్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. సో ఇన్ ది గార్డెన్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ డిగ్గింగ్ ఫోర్క్, హ్యాండ్ కల్టివేటర్, హోయ్ అండ్ రేక్, గార్డెన్ ఫోర్క్. దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ది ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. అండ్ వాట్ ఆర్ ది ట్రాన్స్ప్లాంటింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్? ట్రాన్స్ప్లాంటింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ స్పేడ్, షోవెల్, డిబ్లర్, ట్రాన్స్ప్లాంటింగ్ ట్రూవెల్. దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ది ట్రాన్స్ప్లాంటింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. నేమ్ సమ్ ప్రూనింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. సో ప్రూనింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ ప్రూనింగ్ సికిల్, ప్రూనింగ్ సా, ప్రూనింగ్ నైఫ్, సికేచర్, గార్డెన్ షేర్ అండ్ ట్రీ ప్రూనర్. దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ సమ్ ప్రూనింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్. కమింగ్ టు ది లాంగ్ క్వశ్చన్స్, డ్రా సమ్ డయాగ్రామ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద డిగ్గింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ అండ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ది యూజెస్. అండ్ హియర్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు డ్రా సమ్ డయాగ్రామ్స్, మెజర్మెంట్స్ అండ్ ది యూజెస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ ఇన్ ది మల్బెరీ ఫీల్డ్. అండ్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఈస్ ది ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ అబౌట్ గార్డెన్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ విత్ ఎనీ ఫోర్ డయాగ్రామ్స్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు డ్రా ఎనీ ఫోర్ డయాగ్రామ్స్, లేబుల్ దెమ్ అండ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దే బ్రీఫ్లీ దేర్ యూజెస్ ఇన్ ది మల్బెరీ ఫీల్డ్. అండ్ థర్డ్ వన్ ఈజ్ రైట్ అబౌట్ ప్రూనింగ్ అండ్ ట్రాన్స్ప్లాంటింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ విత్ డయాగ్రామ్స్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ అబౌట్ ది ప్రూనింగ్ అండ్ ట్రాన్స్ప్లాంటింగ్ ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ విత్ సమ్ డయాగ్రామ్స్. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.